This blackcurrant was one I had at home that I didn't get a chance to put in the ground. And these are the last of the strawberries that I had at home in the containers. I brought these in so that I can put them in the ground here with all the other fruit. Have everything in one place. Right, I've put this cucumber up here and tied it to this rope that goes all the way up here, long and right to the other end. It goes all the way along there, right to the other end of the greenhouse. And I put the other cucumber up here and I'm going to tie that to this, and then it will follow this wire right across the other side, and they should give a bit of cover to the tomatoes, because everything is absolutely sweltering in here. Even though I've got the windows full open, it's still absolutely sweltering in here. I mean, I can barely cope. This is an example of what happens when you don't net your brassicas. The pigeons get them. They've left some of this stuff, but that one's got, that one they should pick clean, that one. Fortunately, this is not my plot, but the person who put these in will be absolutely fuming. Hello, it's been raining the last couple of days, so I haven't been in. So doing a quick check in the greenhouse. Nothing seems to be okay. Could do with a bit of watering, but yeah, everything in here seems to be doing all right. Nothing major. Yeah, that all seems to be all right. Apart from Reggie cabbage wipe managed to get onto this one and that one. So I need to get these sorted first. And look at that bugger, it's managed to munch its way through all of that. I just drop them onto the tomato. If they try and eat the tomato, they die. Look at them, big fat caterpillars. So, bit of mess on that one. The others seem alright. I'll have a good look through these later, but they don't seem to be damaged, the others. And that's with me just being away 2 days. Obviously these strawberries have had a good bit of rain, and they should now be starting to have little strawberries. There we go. So they're doing alright. Pumpkins and squash are doing okay. Apart from this one, all the peas have fallen over. Fallen over, but nothing. I haven't damaged anything, so we'll sort this out. The beans and things look okay. They look a bit yellow, but they looked a bit yellow before. That one has obviously, something's had a munch on that, and that one. So obviously the slugs are coming out in force, but they're just having a munch on the old yellow leaves. So I'm not too worried about that. The green leaves seem to be all right. That's just the old yellow leaves that need to be cut off and thrown away anyway. This rhubarb is clearly in the way, because this path is now becoming unpassable because the rhubarb's grown into it. I spent all that time cutting the hedge and the rhubarb's blocking my way. I mean, I can pull those rhubarb leaves, but it's going to be in the way. So I'll move it this winter, get it out of the way somewhere. But everything else seems to be going fine. Even the raspberries in the pots are doing okay. These ones, I'm amazed that the ones that I transferred, they've all come up and not one of them has died. I mean, some of the strawberries in the pots are starting to have flowers and fruit. And this one, it's got fruit on it. Obviously not ripe yet, but yeah, they seem to be going great. So, things seem to be doing okay. And these courgettes and squashes, the leaves are a bit yellow and horrible looking, but actually I was thinking, it's got some nice green leaves coming out, but no, it isn't. Oh, it was a potato. it's definitely not part of the courgette, so it's coming out. This one has got some, I think these are all squashes, so I don't know whether I want a potato sitting in there with it. And look, that one's also got another potato coming out. Right, whilst it's raining outside, it's time to check on the cuttings of sage, rosemary and bay leaves. Now the sage, yes, it did start sort of rooting, but I watered it and forgot about it. Yeah, that's quite tough, so it's, I think it's rooted in. So yeah, you can see it's got quite a good root system, but if I put this in and look after it, it might recover, but I've got plenty of other sage. See this one, just a little bit. I think what a mistake I made was this mixture wasn't well draining enough, and I left this in too long, and it's just sort of withered because it was out of sunlight. I'll leave it in the corner and see if it recovers once it gets a bit of sun. Right, rosemary. These two look all right. Now it looks a bit bad, but it's because the spider weaved a web around it. But these have got green shoots coming out, so they look okay. These ones, not happy, so I think I'm going to take them out, leave them out. As for the bay, that one is actually, these are all new leaves, so that's quite happy. So I'm going to now leave them in the sunshine, but I'm not going to pull them out to see if they've got roots. I'll sort that out another day. But it seems to be okay, because it seems to be budding out, and so is that one, and so is that one, and that one is obviously perfectly fine because it's got the leaves coming out. So yeah, the bay's been a success. The rosemary, partial success. This pot, they didn't take. That one, this one didn't take, but that one seems to be okay. This one would have been okay if I caught it earlier and transferred them, but not to worry because I've got plenty of sage from the seeds I planted, so that's not a problem. Before I go home, I can harvest some more munch too for dinner tonight. And that rhubarb is ready for another picking. Getting a bit sick of rhubarb now. This young sage plant needs potting up. So what I'm going to do is put it into a really big pot, so it can survive in there, because if I put it in another small pot, it's not going to survive. It fell over and all the compost came out, so that's why it's got nothing around it. But that doesn't matter, I'm going to go back to pot it up. You're in the wrong place, bee. Look. Where are you going? Right, so if I fill this up with some soil rather than compost, and then I'll put this in. And I might put some thyme plants around it. This, these pots have had soil in them from the previous tenants. Because sage doesn't like to be, likes well-drained soil rather than rich compost. So this has got lots of stones and stuff in it, so it's perfect for this. A little bit more. Pretty much full to the brim. Leave a little bit of room for mulch. This is so soft, I can just use my hands. Had a little accident, this sage plant fell over. All the compost came out, but seems alright. Those are the first leaves, I think, but the rest of it seems all right. So all it needs is a good drink. I mean, that compost, it's been raining, so that compost was, that soil was all wet anyway, but give it a bit of water, see how it drains. Yeah, that seems to be fine. I think it'll be alright. What I might do is put a couple of thyme plants around it, or I might just mulch it as is. I think I'm just going to mulch it. Yeah, put a bit of mulch around it, just leave it a little bit around the actual plant itself so it's not touching the mulch, and I think that should do all right. Look, the strawberries that are sitting in this pot are producing. Look, get that before the birds do.